I'll be showing you how to dye sections of your hair using food coloring. To start, you're going to want to make a workspace that you can clean easily. You also want some rubber gloves and an old shirt you don't mind getting stained. You always want your food coloring and your gel base. You want to use clear or white shampoo or conditioner, or you can use aloe gel. Today I'll be using my clear Pantene shampoo because I don't own conditioner and aloe gel. I'm kind of afraid to use that. This is the messy part, and I recommend that you put down a plastic bag so you don't get anything everywhere. Or you can put down newspapers, but I don't think it would work as well. Gel base to cover your hair you are dying. I put quite a bit in because I actually wasn't paying attention. I was looking at the camera to see if it was still recording. Now it's time to add the food coloring. Put as much in as you like until it becomes the color you are comfortable with. Then add a few more drops just to be safe. Then you must mix well. I'd like to lighten it. If you want to do so, but not your entire head and just sections like I am, I recommend you use Mark Anthony's Easy Light. I'll put a link down to some pictures and where you can buy it in the description. So you take the section of your hair and you spray it on your hair. Now coat it thoroughly, and if you want to protect your hair from heat, spray a little bit of heat protectant spray, not lotion or anything. Or you can do what I did and use a strengthening treatment. And you take the section that you've just coated in the product and you straighten it until you see your visible lighting. If you want to lighten it more, keep repeating the step until it is at your desirable shape. Because I don't dye my hair very often, I don't have those brushes you're supposed to use that you go with kits, so I am using a toothbrush instead. If you have tools, please feel free to use them. You'll probably end up with a better result. Remember to coat your hair completely from root to tip or wherever you want the color to be. This is the part why you need gloves. To keep my hair from hitting everything, I'll be putting on a plastic bag to the section that I've dyed and putting elastic around it later in the video. For a lighter color, and 5 to 7 hours for it to be all red. Most people recommend you sleep in the dye because food coloring takes longer than actual hair dye. You bleach your hair and you want to keep it natural texture, you can use this silk infusion. It keeps your hair nice and silky and moisturized. Your hair is crazy thin like mine and it breaks off easily, but you get a lot of split ends. Use a split end treatment spray. It repairs damaged ends before they split, but it does not mend them itself.